Vince Gill on the road. TNN next.
For the past 2 years, he's been the Country Music Association's Entertainer of the Year. This week, you'll know why when the road leads superstar Vince Gill to Toledo, Ohio. And CMA Female Vocalist of the Year, Pam Tillis, hits the stage in Richmond, Virginia. Welcome to my crazy life. And reveals why she almost didn't get there.
I didn't know if country music was big enough for my dad and I.
And get a hold of something. It's time to hit the road with Brother Phelps.
There's a ribbon that winds through this country, and it's home to our most beloved storytellers. For 100 years, these byways have carried the hopes of generations of musicians. Today, their descendants roam America, eager to put their dreams into play. Out here, it don't matter where you hail from or where you're headed. This is a story about the journey of life and the wonder of music. Welcome to the road. They stay so close, they sometimes get under your skin. You can't shake them loose because they're in your blood. And whenever you need them, they're by your side in a heartbeat. They're called brothers. Ricky Lee and Doug Phelps sang the praises of this unshakable bond. They are Brother Phelps.
Next on the road, more with Brother Phelps.
People at Saw Thelma and Louise said, "Is that you guys?"
Later, find out just how much Pam Tillis influenced this Academy Award-winning film. And learn what made Vince Gill the Country Music Association Entertainer of the Year.
Brought to you by Neutrogena T-Gel Shampoo. It works. And by Country Weekly. It's country and it's weekly.
Well, then.
Doug and I were raised in a really, really small town. Our father's a minister, and our first music that we ever heard really was gospel music.
There were always guitars laying around the house, auto harps, and we had a piano, always had an old antique piano in the kitchen.
My grandfather and his brothers had a band when they were young, and they did a radio show and things like that, so it's just been country music basically all our lives. Now, try it this way. I believe from the first time that fire was discovered by man, sitting around the fire has always been a great place to fellowship, to draw closer to each other, and that's still today what it is. I just believe around a fire you can find God.
Next, Pam Tillis talks about competing with her famous father.
An identity crisis.
And later, Vince Gill talks about competing with everyone else.
I don't have to prove to the world that I'm an okay guitar player.
She's a child of Nashville who broke with her family's musical tradition to chart her own course. Weaving traditional country, jazz, the blues, and gospel through her singular vocal style, Pam Tillis bridges generations and shows us how to take the past into the future while making the present absolutely her own.
Next, if you think Pam Tillis is wild on stage,
shake the sugar tree.
Wait till you hear about her past.
We were rebels without a pause.
And later, an inside look at Vince Gill before, during, and after the show.
When the road called, I was trying to think of fun things to do, and I thought it'd be fun to introduce everybody to my best bud.
That's me.
Yeah, that's Callie. This is Callie Curry. Callie wrote this little script, Thelma and Louise. It was her first movie, and it did pretty good.
It did. It did. All right.
people that saw Thelma and Louise said, is that you guys? So
I'm sorry to say.
A little bit.
I knew the first time I heard Pam sing that she was incredible. I was working at the Exit Inn as a waitress, and I had never heard her sing, and I was back out in the house when she started singing, and I couldn't believe it. I felt like I was turning to liquid or something. It was the most beautiful thing I'd ever heard.
I had my first number one record, and about 2 weeks later, Susan Sarandon and Gina Davis made the cover of Time, and I said, okay, this is really not funny. I can't compete with this. But it's fun to come out here and visit. And
you're going to have to learn to rollerblade today.
I want to, down at the beach. Okay. You and me, we're there. I was running from something or running to it, but I was really trying to get out from underneath my dad's shadow. I had an identity crisis. And so I thought maybe if I did another type of music, I could assert myself and carve out a niche, a place for myself. And it turns out I didn't have to go that far. It's funny, I met a lot of people in LA that ended up in Nashville. Ended up a big part of today's country music. You know, we're all kind of got a lot of rock and roll influence, but we found a way to express all that and more. Country music has just changed so much that, like I said, I can bring all these different elements of music to the table and come up with something new. You can rock out, and then you can turn around and get downright traditional country honky-tonk sounds. I love it. The simplicity of it. And it all works for me. I found my niche.
When the Road returns, a world premiere performance from Vince Gill.
Vince Gill is exactly who he seems to be. When we watch him pick up his many awards on television, or see him participating in the many charity events that he supports, and in all things musical, he has achieved that rare blend of vocal, instrumental, and songwriting prowess that makes him a musician's musician. Ladies and gentlemen, Vince Gill.
Brought to you by Just for Men, the leader in men's hair coloring. Blends away gray in 5 minutes.
Dropping it down in there. Golf is a great example of a real gentleman's sport. You know, sometimes I don't act like a gentleman out here, but all in all, it's a great game because you kind of police yourself when you've done something wrong. You penalize yourself, and there's not referees and judges and that kind of stuff per se. I enjoy the act more than the act against somebody. I don't enjoy the competition factor in golf, like playing head to head with a friend, as much as I do playing the game. And it's the same with music. I don't think that should ever be. It's never been a competitive thing for me. I didn't want to beat this guy. I didn't want to sell more records than this guy. It's never felt like that to me. In all honesty, I've just wanted to play.
Stay tuned for more with Vince Gill on the Road.
Here in Nashville, there's a facility called the Legends Club. They're building this junior golf facility. These kids, it's a 9-hole golf course, as good as any golf course in the country. You know, it's built and designed by a great designer. I'd always love to have a golf tournament. I wanted all the proceeds to go to kids. That went way beyond our wildest dreams, and as far as how much money we raised and how well the event went. It's going to be one of the best facilities in the country for kids to play golf. The only way an adult can play is if a kid sponsors it. Gives kids something to do. I think that's why kids get in trouble. They get bored. And that's something that golf always gave me, in athletics or any of that kind of stuff. Doesn't matter if it's golf. It just, kids have something to do in their spare time and won't get in trouble. Good rip, buddy.